The humanitarian crisis in Iraq has now entered its second year. Iraq experienced a dramatic surge in violence in 2014 that triggered successive large-scale waves of displacement. Some 2.5 million Iraqis have fled their homes, adding to the 250,000 refugees from Syria the country is already hosting. People run from widespread violence. Entire villages have been burned to the ground. They arrive having lost everything. Some have lost relatives, most have moved several times in the hope of finding safety. They are vulnerable and fragile, both physically and mentally.
I'm from قضاء القائم لأنبار. القائم بمستشفى بس انت تعرف بعد الاحداث يعني بعد دخول المسلحين ما عاد مواد طبيه تيجي انقطعت يعني اصبح انقطعت الطرق كليتها بس وضع الامني هو اللي جبرنا وضع الامني يعني هو اللي جبرنا على انه نفر من هاي المناطق نتيجه قصف الطيران وخاصه الطيران المسير الطيران المسير يعني يقصف اهداف مدنيه وين الاهداف وين تجمعات بشريه وين تجمعات بالاسواق بالاماكن العامه يقصفها الطيران اللي بلا طيار فما قمنا فاضطرينا انه ناخذ اطفالنا ونطلع.
Living conditions of displaced populations are difficult. All over Iraq, people who have been displaced live in overcrowded, substandard shelters. They have no means to purchase food and other basic necessities.
والبيوت ماكو يعني لخ فالناس قاعده بهياكل، قاعده بخيم، قاعده باماكن، احنا عندنا طلاب، عندنا يعني اطفال. والجو هالشوفت عينك هذا الجو البرد الشتاء فالله يسر لنا هذا الهيكل سكننا به بصراحه حتى كان ما بي لا جام لا بي هذا انا جام جبته البارحه ركبت هذا الجام وفتحات جاي نسدسد به ومشي حالنا.
Massive displacement has put an enormous strain on host communities, but many more families fleeing conflict zones have nowhere to go, as their access to safer areas is often restricted along ethnic lines, and international aid is not reaching them. MSF teams strive to assist the populations who have been the most affected and provide medical and humanitarian assistance to areas located as close as possible to front lines. These zones are extremely difficult to access and the population is struggling to get assistance. There, the destruction of infrastructure is the most severe and there are no more services. Many have not seen a doctor for months. In order to provide assistance to those who need it most, our medical teams venture every week into remote areas that are difficult to reach. Mines, booby traps, targeted checkpoints. The extremely volatile security situation is the daily life of Iraqis and the main obstacle our medical teams face on the ground. In spite of security challenges, it is still possible for aid organisations to work. But we see too little international assistance compared to the needs of thousands of displaced Iraqis. States and international donors must step up their support promptly to adequately respond to further impending mass displacements.